Hello Overclockers! In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to remove and reinstall your memory. This video will also help if you need to upgrade what memory you have in your current system so you can multitask like a pro. Reseating memory can seem a little bit scary if you're inexperienced, but it is a simple and easy troubleshooting step. Memory can cause all sorts of strange issues, and it's well worth reseating your sticks to see if it solves any boot problems. The benefit of following this tutorial is to eliminate any simple causes before spending money on a hardware replacement or submitting an RMA. Remember to shut down, turn off, and unplug your PC, including your display beforehand, and let's get started. Start off by turning off your PC and then removing the side panel. The first step is to identify the memory modules. These are nearly always in the same place on every PC and to the right of your CPU and the cooler. The modules are going to probably look a little bit different depending on the manufacturer, the heatsink, RGB lighting, etc. There might be one or two retaining clips keeping your memory in place, and these all need to be undone before each stick can be removed. They're going to be located at either the top or the bottom of each slot, and to unclip them, you simply push them down. The memory will now lift up out of the motherboard and you can carefully pick it up. Try not to hold any of the delicate components. You want to hold onto the heat shield like I'm doing here, or you can also hold onto the edges of the memory. If you're reseating the memory, carefully slot it straight back into the same slot. You want to make sure that it's lined up and apply even pressure across the stick. It will require a firm push in order to click it into place. If you feel like you're forcing it, you've probably not got it in right, or the clips have sort of fallen down, so you want to check that they're undone, and then once again make sure it's lined up and push it straight in. If it's time to install new memory and upgrade your speed or capacity, you'll want to ensure you have the correct memory type. This is likely to be DDR4 or DDR5 in a modern PC, or in an older PC it could be DDR3, DDR2, etc. Your motherboard manual will tell you what it supports and at what speed. You'll also want to check where the memory should be installed if you're not filling all the available RAM slots. If you no longer have your manual, look for the name of the manufacturer and any text on the board to tell you what it is. You should be able to find it online. Remove your new memory from the packaging carefully and identify the notch in the PCB. This is going to line up with the notch that's on your motherboard, so memory can only be installed in one orientation, and you want to double check each stick before pushing it into place. As with many motherboards, our sticks are going to go into slots 2 and 4. You just want to double check that those clips at the top are still undone and then push them in with even force. You'll hear that it makes a nice satisfying click as you push it in. And that clip will go back over the top as well to hold it into place. That's it, you successfully reinstalled or installed your brand new memory, and the final step is to ensure that XMP or DOCP is enabled. You'll want to check your motherboard's manual or pay attention to the text that appears when you turn on your PC, and that'll tell you how to get into the BIOS. So once you're in here, you'll see that there's this setting called XMP. Make sure that that is enabled, and it will make sure that your memory runs at the correct speed so you get all the performance that you've paid for. So click enabled and then click save and exit, and that's it. We hope that you found this video useful. If so, make sure to like and subscribe. If you want to upgrade your memory, why not head over to the Overclockers website and check out the huge variety of memory we have available. Faster memory can improve your PC's responsiveness, and larger memory capacity is useful for gaming, multitasking, video editing, and much more. Links to the products we used in this video, including this beautiful pre-built system, will be in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.